After selecting wood and cutting the wood to 6-inch length, which is the recommended length, next operation is to drill a 1/2-inch hole for the threaded insert. I used my Tenon Master jig and a couple of slight modifications to hold the wood vertically and drilled my holes about 1¼ inches deep, a little longer than the length of the threaded shaft on the end of the opener. For the next step, I stayed right at the drill press. I happen to have a socket adapter that I can put into my chuck, a 5/16 socket, and I was able to drive the threaded inserts right here at the drill press. Don't turn the drill press on, just drive them by turning the chuck manually with your hand and pushing down on your quill feed. If you don't happen to have the socket, you can always use the threaded rod with nuts. There you see the insert, and a little wax just helps everything work a little more smoothly.
Okay, I hope you can hear me here, but the next step is to set up the bandsaw, cut off the corners. I don't normally do this when I'm just making one or two, but when I'm making as many as I am, it's worth the time to set up the bandsaw and knock the corners off, make the turning a little bit easier.
Should have mentioned earlier, you want to mark both ends before you cut those corners off for center. I had marked the ones before I drilled the holes, the inserts, and now I put a little hole in the other end to give me something to start my center into for the turning. Okay, here's everything mounted up in the lathe. See the live center on the back end. We go on the front end, use the bolt and two-nut technique to go into the threaded insert. Just regular chuck to drive it. So I'm going to turn this, and I'm going to turn this one by hand, and I may try some lathe duplicator applications and maybe even my CNC lathe, because as you can see, I have a few of them that I'm planning to turn, so it may need some automation so I don't get too bored. Okay, now you're looking at a handle that I turned by hand and did a very light sanding just to get, you know, some of the tool marks out of it. I don't know if you can see it because it's dark wood, probably not shows up real well, but there's still some sanding scratches in it. So now I want to take that and remount it. I got a very flat surface. I want to remount that so I can copy it now. Okay, so now you're looking at the setup in the lathe duplicator, guard removed for clarity, so that I can make a copy of that hand-turned handle on this piece down below. Here's the shot with the duplicator device that ShopSmith has. You run in, you can see the top, see the cutters down here at the bottom. There's a follower up here at the top. Pretty simple process. Run the follower along your piece, and it cuts it down at the bottom. Gives a pretty good finish. Okay, here's an example of the finished piece. Came off the lathe duplicator, so ran the duplicator on a piece of wood. Got that down here at the bottom as my final cut. Okay, so the question, why don't I just hand turn them all? Only takes, oh, maybe half hour or so to hand turn. Probably takes just as long on the lathe duplicator. Well, I get a nice, smooth, even surface on that barrel. On the one I hand turned, I was very careful to do that, and then I cleaned it up to make sure it was clean. And then by using the duplicator, I get that on every one of them, and so therefore I can carve it. And I hope you can see the carving here in the picture. But this is what I wanted to do all along, was make these look like a beer bottle with a label on them. and then we'll turn them finally into a bottle opener. So here's an example of the final product. This one doesn't have the carving in it. This one was hand turned. But again, that's what it's going to look like in the end. This piece of wood's been sanded, shined up real well, and has the opener installed. So that's the end product. Hope you enjoyed the video, and hope you learned something. Not really my objective to teach wood turning, but just to give you ideas.